Alrighty, well, morning everybody. Well, I just got through doing a pinball stream, about 3.5, almost 4 hours there. So I just switched on over to this game here, Gems of War. So I'm only gonna be on long enough though, just to do the dailies and to get the faction assault done. So shouldn't be that long. I'd probably say roughly an hour, but we'll see as the session goes on. And I totally forgot to start up my media player here, so. Oh, kind of a sleepy way to start. Yeah, especially now, because I'm a bit groggy right now. Just, again, a little bit exhausted from playing pinball. Got a good one here.
Thank you.
this one here. Yeah, I gotta be able to get curses on him. Look at something. There might be a storm outside. Just a stray shower or a thunderstorm if possible. Slight chance. Okay, this is just a shitty starting board. I don't want to be clucking matches all morning. Like clockwork.
Thank you.
Oh, here we go. One of them's submerged. Oh. All day. I gotta turn this down. Search. No greens and reds for me. All day. Like clockwork. Thank you. Oops, we got some merging. Oh yeah. All day. This one was free. Oh wait, we're at the max. So yeah, we're all done. Oh, 13th. So yeah, we're all done. Okay. Next album. From one extreme to the other. Wrong color. Thank you. wasn't paying attention.
Thank you.
apparently.
What a pity. Sergeant Tyler turned in a shabby green robe. He was staring at the once beautiful mushroom house, masterfully carved by himself a long time ago. But now it was just an old, crooked building with pale moss and thick spiderweb covering every curved window. The entrance with a round open door almost collapsed, and a part of the cap roof fell off. Last pair of winters were obviously too harsh, even for such a carefully planned architecture. It was one of the first projects that he mastered all by himself after finishing the carving school of the Great Bog. He was then noticed, and after 5 years of honest hard work, he was invited to plan a project of the Royal Castle, together with a few more famous carvers from the far swamps. It is hard to describe what a huge honor it was for him, and as he saw his name, Brog the Builder, woven with a golden thread amongst others on the huge royal carpet decorating the main castle hall, he stood there, dazed with a clear thought. This is it. This is the biggest creation of my life. However,
like, we got a shitty board
to see that insignificant old creation in front of him slowly vanishing. It was an ordinary house for a simple toad family, but it was where everything started. Well, muttered Brog the Builder to himself, waking up from his own thoughts. This family needs a new home anyway, and I will do my best to create the most beautiful thing in a simple way I've ever made before.
Top guy gets top priority too. He's invulnerable. Bullshit. Nope. Shitty luck. And some more shitty luck. Last long. Bells to call damage for Joe. Well, okay, I guess I misread it.
Quite rustling in the thick swamp bushes got attention for the little toad playing with his friend in the late summer evening. What was that? I didn't hear anything, but it could be fish or just a breeze. No, no, replied the first toad, a little worried. There is surely something bigger than a fish, and it moves above the water. In that moment, a sharp boat's edge appeared out of the plant's thickness. An old, frowning toad was sitting on that boat, made of a dried, oiled water lily, with two big sacks on each side of it. Focused on his own thoughts, he did not smile. Yet, The children could say that he was a friendly creature. "Good evening, little folks," said the boat toad and coughed. "I hope I did not disturb your peaceful game. I am just passing by to see if the south corner of the swamp already has something to offer." "What is it the swamp can offer you?" asked one of the little toads with undisguised interest. "The finest berries in all the kingdom, of course. Now, have a good evening, little ones. I've got no time to waste." With these words, he made two strong pushes with his beautiful, lightweight back and disappeared behind the low willow branches. "Who was that?" asked the youngest toad. "That was old Bob, the berry belly," said the other one proudly. "My granny told me stories about him and his craft. He doesn't like company, but as far as I know, every cure potion we've got for winter is made out of these rare berries he finds. Oh, it is getting late. Let's get back home before everyone starts to worry about us." "I want to be a boat toad too when I grow up," cried the youngest toad, inspired, catching up with his friend up the hill.
Bullshit. Bullshit. Thank you. get my surge. Surge. One. Oh shit, I still got a ways to go. Okay, but yes, no matter how much ibuprofen and Tylenol I'm taking, my back is still my lower back is still bugging me. I might end up coming up short on the event, but yeah, I can't be sitting on the floor here much longer.
It was a dark winter night, and the wind was howling like a thousand beasts. For 3 days,
these are going to be long battles. Chasing the old golem is going to be tedious as fuck to use, so
fairy bug,
I might just have to stick with them.
It was such a rare thing to come across this bug that its shadowed nature started to grow over with dozens of strange stories and myths. Some believed that it was a witch trapped in a body of an insect. The others thought that it could make your deepest dreams come true. The hunter himself heard a lot of unbelievable stories like that, but did not believe in them, to be honest. The only thing he learned from his father is that it was a very rare creature with some half-magical properties, and that its meat could feed a few toad families for at least a month long. So with full dedication, he was chasing the bug over the small hills, turned dark roots, sticking above the frozen ground. When the hunter grew weary after hours of his run, he decided to make a humble camp with a bonfire beneath an old oak tree to warm up his tired bones. He dozed off on a soft bed of moss, and suddenly a truly fairy creature appeared in front of him, floating behind the flames. "I know
what
you want, hunter," whispered the bug, "and you have a choice. You can try to kill me and bring me back to your swamp for the joy of your folk. Or you can make your bow sing the most beautiful song. And if my heart sings to it as well, I will make one dearest dream of yours come true." The hunter kept silence for a while, then stood up, took out his bow, and started playing as if it was a harp. A beautiful melody resonated in the bow's wood, and the fairy bug started to swing slowly. When the song was finished, the bug said, "Tell me, hunter, what is it you wish?" "I wish to feed everyone in my swamp, so that no one would starve this dark winter." "I will do as you wish, hunter," replied the fairy bug, and with a flash of blue light, disappeared in the clear night sky, full of shimmering stars. At least 100 joyful toads met the hunter that night. They couldn't believe their eyes, but each cellar of their mushroom houses was full of food of every sort. What could be enough to feed them the whole winter, and even the neighboring swamp east of the Croaked Forest? The hunter told them his story, and from that time, everyone in this swamp and in the whole kingdom afterwards called him Fog the Singing Bow.
Okay, next album. From one extreme to the other. Matches. so we'll do it again. Matches. Like clockwork. Clockwork. Jesus. God damn. So I'm gonna have to go straight to the boss on this. Pretty much it happened right at the start of the floor. Well, apparently I can't do that. Fuck that. At this level, kinda need my hero in a whoa. So yeah, I just gotta go ahead and do some sort of cleaning up. We're gonna call it a sesh. like I said, I'll explain here in a second. Alrighty, yeah, that's gonna do it for me, everybody. I'm gonna go ahead and call it good. Yeah, because my lower back is just hurting like hell right now. So I gotta get up on my feet, sit on the couch, do something. But yeah, I gotta get off that. So, plus the usual post-production stuff. Gotta get all that done. Blog as well. So, I don't think they're gonna be doing construction. It's Sunday. It's the weekend and all that. So, but even then, I'm getting a nap in there. Won't hurt. Still got to do my blog in case I didn't say so already, but basically, it's going to be a fairly busy, active morning, so. But otherwise, hey, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that. And I should be on again tonight. Once again, my default time is midnight, but as has been going on lately, I've been on a lot earlier, like between 10 to 11, so. Yeah, just kind of look out for that. Oh, and the times are U.S. Central. So, until then, thanks again for coming by, everybody, and I'll see you all next time. Hopefully, when I'm not a hurting unit.